everyone, this is Hedionic. In this second part of op amp circuit tutorial, we'll be looking at three other important circuits. They are the integrator, the differentiator, and the logarithmic amplifier using op amps. So first in line is the integrator circuit. As the name suggests, an integrator produces the integral of its input as the output. So to obtain such an output, we just have to replace the feedback resistor with a capacitor. That way, in this case, instead of a feedback resistor, we have a feedback capacitor. So here we have a non-inverting amplifier or inverting amplifier with its feedback path through a capacitor CF. So now we have to find out the gain of this circuit. So applying virtual short and the principle of zero current, you can see that if this is I1 and this is IF, I1 is equal to IF because no current is drawn by the op amp. Now I1 is the potential difference divided by the resistance. So here the V1 is 0 volt. So applying virtual short, V2 would also be equal to 0 volt. So the potential difference divided by resistor is I1 equal to VI divided by R1, or VI minus 0 by R1. Now the current through a capacitor is given by IF is CF into dV by dt. V is the potential difference. So we get CF into dV0 by dt. So equating these two, we would get I1 equal to IF implies VI by R1 equal to CF into dV0 by dt with a minus sign because the direction is opposite. Now here dV0 by dt is also equal to minus 1 by R1 CF into VI. So integrating both sides, we can obtain V0 as minus R1 by minus R1 minus 1 by R1 CF into integral VI dt. That is, the output voltage is directly proportional to the integral of the input. So this is the output of our integrator. Actually, there would also be a constant here which is proportional to the value of the voltage at time zero. So this integrator has a drawback. That is, if we are supplying a DC voltage, this capacitor will act as open circuit. So this would basically be an open loop circuit which has very high or infinite gain. So to avoid such irregularities in certain frequencies, we would generally connect a resistor in parallel, RF, with in parallel to the capacitor. So this is our practical integrator. So the second circuit that we are discussing is a differentiator. Like in integrator, we only have to make a small modification to the non-inverting amplifier. That is, we add a capacitor in the input path. So we modify a simple inverting amplifier by replacing this resistor with a capacitor C1, like shown here. Now we have to prove that the output is the different derivative of the input. By applying virtual short, we can see that as this potential is 0 volt, this point would also have the same potential, that is 0 volts. Now the current here IB is 0, so the current I1 and current I2 should be equal. That is, the voltage, the current flowing through this capacitor is, like in the previous case, is I1 is C1 dVI by dt, and the current I2 is the potential difference divided by the resistance, which gives minus VO by R, that is the resistance, or RF you can write. Now equating these two terms, C1 dVi by dt equals minus V0 RF, or V output voltage V0 equals minus RF C1 dVi by dt. That is, the output voltage is the derivative proportional to the derivative of the input of the op-amp circuit. So this is our differentiator. We ensure that you don't confuse this with the difference amplifier we studied in the previous module. So also, to avoid practical disadvantages of this circuit, we normally connect a resistor in series with this capacitor and a capacitor in parallel with this resistor. So this is our practical differentiator circuit. Now the third one is logarithmic amplifier. In logarithmic amplifier, we get an output which is a log of the input. So for obtaining such an output, we connect a transistor in the feedback path in with its base at zero potential. And this is an emitter connected to the output. Since the collector is first, we apply the virtual short, that is, this voltage and this voltage is zero and the current is zero through these paths. So on applying virtual short, we can find that the collector of the transistor is at 0 volt, so is the base of the transistor. So it essentially acts like a diode, and the current through it can be written as IE equals IS e raised to QVE by KT minus 1. Here this IS is emitter saturation current, and VE is this voltage developed across the emitter base, and K is the Boltzmann constant. Also T is the absolute temperature in Kelvin. So if this current is IC, then the same current passes through the transistor. So here IE can be replaced by IC and can be written as IC equals IS into e raised to QVE by KT minus 1. Therefore IC by IS equal to e raised to QVE by KT here minus 1. As IC by IS is a very large number, we can neglect this 1 over here, and this can be rewritten as IC by IS equal QVE by KT. From the circuit, like as in the previous and the one before, we can see that the IC current is VI by R1. That is, IC equals VI by R1. And here VE, or the emitter base junction voltage, is equal to the output voltage, that is, in magnitude they are equal and sign they are opposite, therefore minus VO is VE. So before substituting these, we can simplify this by taking natural log on both sides, which would give us QVE by KT is equal to log of IC by IS. Here it becomes log of E, that is, which is equal to the function itself. So here we are now replacing it with the corresponding terms, and QVE VO by KT equals log VI by R1 IS. Here this R1 into IS is some voltage which we call as V reference, and on taking these terms to the other side, we get VO equals minus KT by Q log, natural log of VI by V reference. We replace R1 IS by V reference. So the output voltage is in a way proportional to the logarithm of the input voltage. So in this module we discuss the integrator, differentiator and the logarithmic amplifier, and I'll be following it up with more videos on other circuits like the instrumentation amplifier, the comparator, etc. So subscribe my channel and stay tuned. Thank you.